India, Bombay, Mumbai. The gate up here, I believe, is the India Gate, or Gate to India, nonetheless. So the two flowers there, either side of the archway, it's repeated on each side also. And just a bit of a pan around, so there's a lot of people here today. This is India. We have the statues around the side here, but anyway, so rather statuesque building up here, grand building with the domes, also looking out onto the port. Trying to get onto the ferry here to get to the Elephanta Caves. Okay, a 360 degree pan around. With the gateway right here and military ships. Just here in Bombay. So this is part of the structure with the line coming through here. The oil pipelines coming out over the sea with the containers over here. This is part of the oil facilities here in India. Now, India itself extracts about 3% of the oil that it requires, apparently. So, this is the pier to get onto the island, Elephanta Island, or to the Elephanta Caves here in Mumbai, India. Getting across, looks like they're going three wide here to get the people crossing just to get onto the pier over here, so things are busy. $500 for the foreigner. Notice the difference in price for the locals. So this is the north-facing main cave here on Elephanta Island. Just a note with the doorway here and the pillars is that you have a four-sided nature to the pillars, then an eight-sided nature. You have the lotus there, and also up here you have the etheric type swirl within the configuration. As I've done time and time and time and time again, the pillar, I refer to it as a pillar of further etheric magnetic light. In this case, you see a pillar of fire. You see Shiva in there, just as you have the God, basically the same God of the Bible, in a pillar of fire also. The tree would also double as a pillar, and the fire is a fire that doesn't burn. Here you see Freemasons within what I would suggest is a depiction of further light. Let's proceed on. The four-sided nature to these pillars becomes apparent with various entities that can be seen, I would certainly suggest, in a way emerging from the pillar. Okay, within the caves here, and the main entity for these caves, the devotion would be Shiva, and you have the four faces up here, the four astral faces.
So far, we've been looking within the main cave
and the lighting is poor, so it was hard to film at times, as per some other caves as well, but nonetheless. We'll now look at the plan of the cave, the main cave, the Elephanta Caves of Elephanta Island, and the circle there for a start. Now that's where perhaps Nandi the bull would sit and face towards the lingam there, the main lingam. Now that would be within the cellar, the sort of four-sided room. It was very hard to sort of walk in and film this. That room would have the eight guardians around it, and in a way they would represent a door to the outside of that kind of main door in each case. I would suggest at their heads, either indicative of the light perception from the Ajna or crown chakra, behind you sort of have the circle there, and you've kind of seen that circle about the either side of doorways also. So you can see the kind of a configuration of the doorways, and you would have that inner pillar of light, and I would suggest that the whole thing represents light, strangely enough. Even the eight guardians around the outside in this case. Jumping a little, I was in the town of Berry in New South Wales, Australia, very recently, and I noticed a doorway there also, and among other aspects, I just found it similar to the doorway depicted at the Elephanta Caves. Beyond that, at the Elephanta Caves, you have those swirls, and indeed, on this building, this hotel, you have those swirls also. I would suggest that everything kind of emanates out, in a way, of the central pillar of light, the central pillar of light, that of the lingam. Now, talking about lingams, what I noticed, so you have the lingams, of course, and you actually can sort of see the lingam in India and in neighbouring countries, but beyond that, particularly when I was in the Egyptian Museum of Antiquities in Cairo, I noticed the configuration for the lingam. And even though you don't have the physical part of the lingam there, I got it. I got it, and there I took many photos of different ones within the museum. You actually would have the pillar there. It's just not sort of physically represented as it is in India. And then, not only that, as I got about further in the museum, I came across this scenario with the false doorway and the lingam right there beside it. There is so much I could say about all this, and I'm not going to say it in this video. But surely you can see the similarity between these sort of false doorways that you can see depicted in the Cairo Museum versus the false sort of doorways, I would suggest, with the lingam set up at the Elephanta Caves. I'd like now just to go to a little bit of footage from Egypt on the Giza Plateau with a false doorway before we get back to the Elephanta Caves. On the inside here is one of the false doors, Egyptian false doors. It's a bit of a classic, the classic type. And it's just within the little hole here to the side of the second pyramid. This, the pyramid of Khafre.
Second one, Khafre. Yeah.
So the second pyramid here. A further note before we proceed, you can see the raised outer aspect to the doorway on the Giza Plateau there, with the recessed inner parts to the doorway. With this in mind, if we go to Sutri in Italy, you can see exactly the same artistry being used there.